Listening Library presents Pirate School Number 2, Ahoy, Ghost Ship Ahead, by Bryan James. Read for you by Bryan Kennedy.
Chapter 1, Rotten Trouble. The waves crashed against the side of the Sea Rat. The sky was dark too. We were sailing right into a storm. The whole pirate ship rocked back and forth. "Arr, the sea is pretty rough today," I said. I held onto the mast to keep my balance. "This is going to be a big storm."
"Aye, it's making me a little seasick," Gary said, covering his mouth.
His face was turning as green as the seaweed slop we'd had for breakfast.
"Blimey! Whoever heard of a pirate getting seasick?" Aaron asked.
He held his gut and laughed.
"A pirate getting seasick is like a bird being afraid of heights." "Arr, stop teasing. You were seasick once, too," Vicky snapped.
"Never," Aaron bragged.
"Uh-huh,"
Vicky argued. She's Aaron's twin sister, so she'd known him every day of his entire life.
"What about the time on our last ship when that seagull made an oops on your head? Then you made an oops all over the deck?"
Aaron's face turned red. He folded his arms and turned his back to us.
"That was different," he said with a huff.
"Still counts," Vicky smiled, her dark eyes twinkling.
I looked at Gary. He still looked sickish.
"Maybe you should go below decks." "I'll be ship-shaped soon," he said. "I don't want to miss a single second of pirate school. Besides, I think it's the seaweed slop that's making me sick."
"Aye," I said. "That grub sure is gruesome." It was Rotten Tooth's very own recipe. Good thing he wasn't always the cook. Rotten Tooth was the first mate. He was the meanest, dirtiest pirate on the ship. He only made his seaweed slop before storms.
"It be good luck," he told us.
He said it was a secret recipe. He should have said it was a stinky recipe. But his cooking wasn't even the worst part about Rotten Tooth. The worst part was that he was also our pirate teacher. We had all come to this ship to go to pirate school. But so far, Rotten Tooth hadn't taught us a thing.
"Where is old Rotten Guts anyway?" Aaron asked. "He's late for class."
Just then, we saw Ina running up from the galley and onto the deck. As usual, she was wearing fancy clothes. Ina might not dress like a pirate, but that didn't mean she didn't want to become one.
"Arr, Rotten Tooth's on his way," she shouted.
Then she covered her mouth to hide a giggle.
"He fell asleep with his face flat down in a bowl of slop."
"I?" we asked.
"I," Ina said. "And he blew bubbles in it when he snored."
Then we all laughed.
"I wonder if that's the pirate lesson he'll teach us today," Vicky joked. "He'd probably tell Captain Stinkybeard that he was teaching us how to hold our breath and dive for sunken treasure."
"Aye," I agreed. Rotten Tooth always told the captain he was teaching us more than he was. One time, he told Captain Stinkybeard that he taught us how to wipe the deck clean of our enemies. He forgot to mention the enemy was only grime and that our swords were mops. All he taught us was how to swab the deck. That's because Rotten Tooth didn't think kids could be good pirates. Lucky for us, Captain Stinkybeard was on our side.
"Yo ho ho," Aaron said in his deepest voice. "I'm Rotten Face."
He pretended to walk around like Rotten Tooth. He stomped his feet and made grumbling noises.
"Psst, Aaron,"
Gary whispered, pointing his finger and trying to get Aaron to turn around. Just then, a big hand came to rest on Aaron's head. Aaron gulped. His dark eyes opened wide.
"Aye?"
Rotten Tooth's voice boomed in our ears.
"Then who be I?"
We looked up and saw Rotten Tooth's green teeth snarling at us. His face was covered with slop, and he looked meaner than ever. Aaron stuttered. He was frozen with fear.
Arr, stop ye sniveling and falling, Rotten Tooth said.
Aye, aye, Aaron said, and lined up with the rest of us. We all stood as straight as we could. Rotten Tooth paced back and forth in front of us.
Normally, I'd make shark bait out of anyone caught making fun of me, he said.
We all held our breath. I thought for sure he'd have us scrubbing dishes and washing decks for the rest of our days.
But orders be orders, and me orders are to teach ye barnacles a lesson.
We weren't getting punished. I couldn't believe my ears. I asked. I was too excited to stay quiet. We're going to learn something today? I couldn't wait for our first real pirate lesson.
Aye, ye will learn something, Rotten Tooth snarled.
Then he leaned in close and laughed. His laughter boomed as loud as the thunder off the starboard bow, and the wind blew his stinky breath right into our faces. Now I felt a little seasick. I held my nose. Something sure smelled rotten to me. Chapter 2. From Sea to Stormy Sea. I held onto my pirate hat as the wind whipped around. Arr, it's really stormy up here in the crow's nest, I said, wiping the rain from my face. Aye, Vicky agreed. Her normally reddish-brown hair looked black. How long did Rotten Tooth say we had to stay up here? Ina made a face. Then she squeezed the water out of her skirt.
Long enough to get completely soggy, she said.
Then she looked at her hands and stuck her tongue out of her mouth.
My fingers are all wrinkly. Yuck!
Don't be such a pollywog, Aaron said. Pollywog was pirate speak for calling Ina a baby. Besides, it's not so bad. The crow's nest is our secret hideout.
Aye, but not when it's storming,
Ina shouted and stomped her foot. That was true. The crow's nest was our favorite spot on the ship. It's where we came to talk secret pirate kid things. But during a storm, it was always better to be warm and dry below decks.
Aye, Gary said. Soon it'll be our secret swimming pool.
I looked at my feet. The water was already up to my ankles. Aye, we'd better use the bucket to bail out the water. Gary picked up the bucket by his feet. He scooped up the water and tossed it over the side. But Gary didn't have very good aim. The bucket of water splashed right onto Vicky.
Sink me, Vicky said. We're going to turn into fish up here. I think I'm already turning into a fish,
Ina said, showing us her wrinkled hands again.
Aye, because you had to make fun of Rotten Tooth, we have to get all wet,
Vicky said, poking Aaron in the stomach.
Blimey, it's not my fault Rotten Guts can't take a joke, Aaron said. Besides, Gary got you all wet, not me.
Vicky was about to argue some more, but I interrupted.
Avast, you're missing the most important part, I finally said.
My friends all looked at me.
What part?
Gary asked. The part about us finally getting our first real pirate duty, I answered.
Where are the ship's lookouts?
I said proudly.
But Rotten Tooth only sent us up here to get us out of the way, Aaron said.
And to get back at us for your teasing,
Vicky reminded Aaron.
I agreed.
But he also told us to keep our eyes on the seas for rocks, reefs, and any other pirate ship that's being tossed by the storm. Being a lookout is a big job during a storm. My friends all thought about what I'd said. Gary took off his glasses and rubbed his eyes. Ina put her finger up to her mouth. Aaron and Vicky squinted their eyes. That meant they were all thinking very hard.
Pete's right,
Vicky finally said.
Let's stop bellyaching and start doing our duty.
Aye, aye, Gary agreed.
Aye, we'll show Rotten Tooth that we're the best lookouts on the sea rat, Aaron said.
Ina frowned.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.